Oh, hello, you. Welcome back. Been a while. Haven't been posting for a bit. Had a kind of Rory McIlroy moment, a post-Masters meltdown. Things weren't going right, shots weren't coming out well. So just decided to simplify. Stop the filming, get back to basics. And one of the things that happened in that period was a conversation with someone you know, which I'll tell you about in a moment, that has completely changed my approach to golf. Because as much as it's about grip and technique and knees and hands and feet, the single biggest thing I learned from this conversation was that golf is in the mind. So we've simplified, we've calmed it down, we've gone golf woo-woo. And in a way, how could you not? Look at the surroundings. Spring has sprung. The course isn't completely soaking. I mean, it's, apart from that sort of coffin-shaped bit of sand, it's in absolute pristine condition. How could you not imbibe the surroundings, revel in them? This conversation changed everything. And I genuinely think it could change your approach to golf too. So I'll come on to what was said and who it was said to me by in a few moments. But I wanted to tell you what has happened in the intervening time, not least to the old handicap, which has dropped from 18 to, as you saw on the screen earlier, about 15. Hang on, I just knocked this in for birdie. But that's okay. We've gone zen now. We don't mind those. Nothing wrong with a no problem par. And when it does go wrong, like that, sure, it can get frustrating. Sure, you can get annoyed. But what do I expect? I'm not very good at golf. I'm also not very good at filming, because this was meant to be me taking the drop shot, because I lost the ball, but I didn't film it. And it's just sort of largely me talking to myself. But again, fine. Pitch into the green here at the third. Didn't quite get it right. And back down the hill. But look how beautiful it is. It's amazing. So head up, lad. There we go. So a couple of things have happened before I come onto this conversation. First thing to say is, look at them shoes. I've taken the advice of Malcolm and Bobman and invested in some decent golf shoes, and they have made a difference. They're sturdy, they're comfortable, and apart from the horrendous blisters for the first 2 weeks of use, they've been really good. That five wood wasn't good. But again, didn't hit the club on the ground, so improvement. Out of the rough. Fine, maybe we can get up and down on the par 5 fourth. Lovely stuff. So the golf shoes have been an investment in it and seem to be doing the business. Get in. That's par, that's good. And the other part of the change is realizing what I'm aiming for. No point in really chasing 79 or 78 or just trying to continuously beat my best score, because I'm not going to. One round in 10, maybe. 20, maybe. But trying to do it every round is going to end in tears. Not literally. Oh, it's fine. So, having taken some advice, not having a lesson, I just want to play to my handicap. If I can play to my handicap every round, I'll get from 18 to 10, no problemo. Shove that over to the right again. Keep kind of slicing the driver, which is a bit of a problem. Found the ball after a bit though, so whack it out. And that's the aim. Just keep playing to the handicap. So I get a shot a hole, So I now approach the first shot as, you know, basically a freebie. Take the freebie and you've got four or three shots depending from that point. And that has been one of the big changes. Little thumbs up to the greenkeeper there after that 9-iron onto the green, which was actually really good. So here we go. Here's a par putt on the hardest hole of the course. I've got two putts from here, really. Given I get at least a shot a hole, I'll probably get two shots on this hole. So what am I worried about? And I nailed it anyway. It's all in the brain. The other thing that's happened is the channel. Turns out people are watching it, and which is, you know, part of the aim, really. And as a result, off the post, as a result, ended up being invited to a thing in Parliament by the Royal and, I'm going to say agricultural, I don't know, the people who run the Open, the RNA, those people. And it was a presentation about, just slice that right, it was a presentation, Anna had to drop a shot here, so. It was a presentation about how much golf contributes to the UK economy. You might think that sounds boring, but let me tell you now, it's a lot of money. Yeah? 0.3% of the entire UK economy is golf-based. It makes up 10% of all of UK sport spending. Some £5 billion. Half of which were those shoes, but again, blisters aside, they were good. Oh, that's a bit frustrating. So it's nice to meet those people and talk about golf. Oh, okay, so that, yeah, that didn't go too well. Flicked off the trees and, yeah. But it's just a process, you know, keep zen, keep calm, relax.
Fucking stupid.
Yeah, still learning, really, you know. Got to learn. That's a five wood, that's gone down the middle, that's a chip on. Can we get up and down? Ladies and gentlemen, this new approach means, no, not yet. Maybe soon. Oh. And again, missed it. So three putting, again, one of the most frustrating things, but you know, we're going full zen. Front nine done. There's the scream. Hits the tree, bounce out, goes onto the fairway. I forgot to film the drive on the 10th, so that's my second shot. Here we go onto the green. Nice little bump and run with an 8-iron. That's getting a bit close. Hello, it's going in. No, it isn't. Frustration, but nothing. Okay, maybe a bit more than frustration. The Zen thing's hard to work on. The thing was that the conversation that led to this new approach was with a man called Chris Evans. You know Chris Evans off the TV. He's done all the radio. Loves his cars. Loves his golf. He was a big, big, big golfer. So we got talking in the green room of this morning about golf. And he said these words. Just three words. I have massively shanked this, by the way. It's gone in here. Look, I could dig it out, though. Look at that. It is absolutely stuck. Look at those shoes. Out it goes. Here we go again. Don't like it. Don't like it. Really don't like it. Hate it. Nope. Let's go. Just going to the back of the green. Anyway, we were having this conversation, and he was very, very kind about the programme. Even actually, even said on his own show that he'd met me.
Came down to say hello, as did Tom Swarbrick from LBC, by the way. He's very tall and handsome.
So we were chatting away, and he was telling me all about radio and his views on it, and really interesting to listen to him because he knows, the guy knows what he's talking about. He's a legend, isn't he? Oh, had a chat with the greenkeeper there. He knew it was close. Those greens do look good, though, don't they? I mean, again, council-run course, so I don't think you can say fairer than that. It's about 30 quid to play around here. That's why all those leaves came down, is I actually hit the tree with the club, but it worked out. Get this on. Anyway, so we were having the conversation, and he was talking about why he wasn't really playing anymore, why he'd stopped playing. Said he didn't really have the time, and that he was doing much more gym and running, and he'd run the London Marathon and stuff, which is deeply impressive anyway. Oh, come on. Slightly falling apart here. But we ended up talking about golf and about his view on what golf is. And I was saying about the YouTube channel, and I was saying about trying to get from 18 to 10 without having any lessons. And he, like everybody who's any good at golf, said, yes, of course that's possible. Of course you can get from 18 to 10 without lessons. It might take a bit longer if you don't have lessons, but you will end up eventually getting there. But you need to know one key thing, right? And the key thing he said that has changed the approach, changed the mindset, got me back filming again, is this. Golf is meditation. That's all he said. There's nothing moving. There's nothing coming at you. The ball's not rolling. The ball's not coming. There's nobody charging at you. There's no pressure from anyone else. Golf is meditation. So that's how we're going to approach it from now on. Shoot the handicap. Don't worry about 78s or 79s. Apply no more pressure than is necessary, because I don't know that I'm ever going to play golf again. I'm just going to meditate my way around a golf course. Look at it. It's the perfect slice of peace and quiet in which to meditate. You do have to think about it a bit. I'd normally hit drive on this, but I went for 5-iron because I thought I don't want to end up in the trees. Anyway, meditation. Hit that one really badly. Because now when I go around the golf course, I'm not just going to be calm.
I'm fucking zen.